Hi everyone, this is Albert from the Center for High Performance Computing at the University of Utah, and welcome to this tutorial on running Slurm interactive jobs. So the first question is, what is an interactive job? An interactive job is a job that gives you console access on one of our compute nodes. So instead of running your job through a bat script, you would simply connect to your interactive session and then run work as if you were on an interactive node, except that you can use the full capability of the compute node to your heart's content. So the next question is when to run an interactive job. So you would use this in instances where you have a software that requires a GUI to run in multi-core or multi-threaded fashion. Any testing of an MPI or a parallel or multi-threaded software should be done on an interactive job. And in general, if you want to just play around with one of our multi-core compute nodes to either learn things or to get a feel for how they perform, an interactive job is also a good way to do that. So how do you start an interactive job? You use the command srun, just like that. Now, with normal bat scripting, you would usually use an sbatch directive, but for srun, you have to type in all of your configuration information manually. So this can result in a fairly long command, but it's all right because that's how you do it. Now, one thing that you could consider is typing all of this and putting it into an alias, and that's perfectly acceptable. Just make sure that you know what you're doing. So the first thing that you usually want to specify is the wall time, which is hours, minutes, seconds. Now, you don't usually want to run these interactive jobs for more than 1 to 4 hours. I don't recommend going beyond that, but a 4-hour session is usually plenty for anything that you'll be doing on an interactive session, so don't go beyond that. You'll want to specify your account. I'm going to use owner-guest today. A partition, which is going to be King's Peak guest to go along with owner guest. And then you need to put in the number of tasks and the number of nodes. So for an interactive session, you probably don't want to use more than two to four nodes at most. I'm just going to use one node because I don't really need that much for this instance. And then you need to specify the number of tasks. Now, I'm going to specify 16 because I want a node that has at least 16. If you specify more than that, then you'll may not be able to fit that into a single node. Now, the last little bit, which I'm running off the end of my screen here, but is the most important part, is specifying a PTY, which is a terminal. So you do --PTY, followed by the command for what you're going to run. PTY sets it up so that you can run in a terminal state, which is something that would not normally be set if you were doing simply a simple bash job. Now for this command, you can do one of two things. You can do /bin/bash -l, or you can do /bin/tcsh -l. So this simply selects the command or the shell that you want to run. So my preference is for bash, and so I'll use that. If you want to use TCSH, there's nothing stopping you from doing that, and if that's your preferred shell, then by all means. So once you have this all typed out, then you can launch the request for it. And at first it will tell you that this is queued and waiting for resources. And then you might have to wait a little bit to see whether or not you'll get a job. Now if there are nodes available, then you should get it fairly quickly. But you might have to wait a little bit. And here we can see now that I've been allocated my resources, and now I'm actually running on one of the compute nodes. And you can tell this by the designation of the node that I'm running on. I'm running on KP047 right now, which is different from where I was before, which was simply King's Peak 1. So on this node, I can do anything I want within reason. Don't run the memory out, that can cause problems on the node. But generally speaking, unlike the interactive nodes, I can do any heavy-duty computing I want to do. So the other thing that's nice about Slurm is that when you do these interactive sessions, X-forwarding is automatically applied. So if I were to use our standard program XEyes, You can see it went behind there. Come here. You can see that the compute node is actually running XIs for me. So, if you want to use a graphical interface, there's nothing that you have to do extra to get that. You just have to make sure that when you are logging in that you use ssh.sh(x), or in my instance that I'm using fastx. Now, of course, this example needs some actual running, so I'm going to use my same example again. So I have this runqe.slurm script. Now let's say I wanted to test the different commands in that. So I would start out by setting up my environment by doing a module purge followed by a module load intel impi qe. Now the program that you use in Quantum Espresso is PWX, and so you can see that if I try and run it right now, it gives me a bunch of complaints because I'm not using my MPD. So if I do MPI run pw.x followed by the input, which is just my hist in here, then you can see that my program is actually running. And this is using all 16 cores on my node right now. So if I do a top real quickly, you can see that I have 100% of those nodes recently with this PWX program. Now it just stopped doing things for me. If I restart my job, you can see that it's done now. And so you can see that you can run MPI jobs very nicely and very easily on an interactive session, and you can do so in a testy, break things sort of way. Now the last thing that you need to know is simply that if you are done with your session, then you should really exit out of the session so that you can free up resources for other people. And since this is a shell environment, you can simply do that by typing in the exit command, and you are done. And with that, that's everything I have to show you today. I hope you enjoyed that, and if you have questions, then you can contact us at CHCC via email at issues@chcc.utah.edu. You can also visit our offices in INSCC 405. Thanks for watching.